Hey, hi guys, this is Bakapaj Jolikar. In today's Selenium tutorial, we'll discuss how to develop Selenium Cucumber BTD framework. Let us jump to the high level agenda. First, we'll create a sample Maven project. Then we'll customize Maven project. Then after that, we'll be discussing how to create future file, step definition file, and test runner class. So finally, we'll be creating one utility method so that reads the properties file like URL and all, file path and all. So we'll be discussing what is the scenario we will be using to automate the web application. Then I'll show you a sample demo. So when we create a first Maven project, the structure of the Maven project will be looking like this. It will be having src main Java, src main resources, src test Java, src test resources, and other folders like src target and pom.xml file. So when we customize this particular project, so it will be looking like this. So first we'll be deleting all the folders like all source and the test resources and Java resources folders. We'll be creating a fresh src folder. Under that, all the packages like stepdef, separate package where all the step definition contains. And one more package we'll be creating, test runner. Under that, our where exactly we'll be specifying the features to run. And we'll be creating one utility class that is a properties file reader under the utility package. Then we'll be creating one future folder. Under that, all the features will be there. Then we'll be creating one resource. Under that, I have created one browser config.properties that contains the browser URL. You can mention a file path and sheet name and all. So this is the target. Under target, you can see the index.html. That is a report generated when we are executed this particular test runner class. So finally, we'll be creating one testng.xml file. We'll be executing testng.xml file. We'll be treating testng.xml file as a suit file. So let us jump to the Eclipse IDE and quickly create a sample Maven project, and we'll customize the Maven project. So here I'm clicking on the file. I'm going to new, then other. Here I'm searching for the Maven folder. So if you look at here, under Maven folder, you'll be seeing one Maven project option. Just say next and select this particular checkbox. Click on next button. Here you can give the group ID. So in my case, what I'm giving is com dot test automation. So next artifact ID is nothing but in similar way how you have provided a group ID, you can provide the artifact ID. So this artifact ID is nothing but your project name. So here what I am mentioning is, here I'm mentioning Selenium Cucumber BDD framework. So that's it. So you can specify the name of the project and description for this. So what I will do is just I will copy this and I'll paste it in name and description. So I'm clicking on finish button. So if you look at here, so this is the same structure what we have seen in our slides in the beginning of this tutorial. So what I will do is I'm going to delete all these, but all the four, five folders. So what I'll do is just I'm creating the one src folder. Right click on the project, go to the new ERSA folder. Let us say just click on cancel here. Right click on the project, go to the new. So here I'm creating the source folder. That's the reason here I'm selecting the source folder. I'm giving the name of the source folder as SRC. Click on finish. In the similar way, under source, I'm creating three packages. First one is com.testautomation.stepdef. That's it. I'll create another two packages, one for test runner, one for the utility method. So simply I'm deleting this one. So click on the SRC and create another two packages. Here I'm saying com.testautomation. I'll say test runner. And click on finish button. In the similar way, I will create one more package. Here I'm just saying the package name as com.testautomation.utility. Click on finish button. So under this, I will create one class in each of the packages. In the first package, stepdef, I'll create one class called you just specify the class name. So in my case, I'm specifying YouTube search stepdef. So click on finish button. Under test runner, I'm creating one class called test runner. Click on finish button. Under utility, I'm creating one more class called properties file reader. So that's all. Click on finish button. So SRC part is done. We need to create another two folders. One is future folder, another is resource folder. Let us create those two folders. Right click on the project, go to the, now you select the folder. So here you mention the futures . So in the similar way, I will create one more folder called resources. So that's it. Click on finish button. Under resources, I'll specify the future file. Right click on the future. Create one file. You need to select here it as a file. So here you mention the future file name. YouTube search dot future. So all future file contains the dot future format. So click on finish button. Why I have specified the YouTube search stepdef is we are going to automate the YouTube website. So that's the reason even I have specified the name of this particular future file as YouTube search.future. So once we create the folder structure, we will discuss the scenario, then we'll start writing our code. I think it has got stuck. Just give me a second. So let me try to close this. Yeah, it has got created, YouTube search dot future. Under resources, I'm creating one dot properties file where I'm mentioning the my YouTube URLs. So here I'm again going to the file because I wanted to create dot properties file. So here I'm mentioning browser hyphen config dot properties. Click on finish button. So that's it. So let us jump to the automation scenario which we are going to write our code. So first I will open this particular browser, Chrome browser, and I will type youtube.com. Then I will search here, like I'll search Selenium by Backup Iron. So this is my once we enter this particular search criteria, I will be clicking on this particular button. So this is my scenario. So let us jump to the Eclipse IDE here. So first what I will do is I will open this particular pom.xml file. Here you'll be in overview tab, click on the pom.xml. So here you'll be seeing all this information, what we have provided, artifact ID and group ID and all. So this is the project name and this is our description. This all information we have provided when we are creating the project. So that's it. So here you need to mention the couple of dependencies and plugins. So that I have in the in text file. So here I'm just copying this all the plugins and dependencies. I will explain you what are the jar files I have mentioned and which version of jar files I have mentioned. That's it. So if you look at here, I have mentioned the one property, then I have mentioned one Maven Surfite plugin. That is a version of 2.19.1. Then I have mentioned the java.exe file, where exactly in my system located. That is for Maven compilation purpose. Then I have mentioned one more Maven Cucumber reporting version of 3.15.0. This all reporting part. So coming to the dependency part, so I have mentioned the Selenium Java version of 3.11.0 and I have mentioned the TestNG with the version of 6.9.8. Then I have mentioned Cucumber TestNG version of 1.2.5. So that's it. So we need to close this particular dependency tag. So there's a reason in the line number 75 we are getting the error. Just I have saved it, so it will go this particular error because it is building it. Once building is done, it is that particular error will be going out. That's all. Don't worry about this particular pom.xml, this all properties and the plugins what I have mentioned. Just you can comment your email ID in the comment section of this below video. I will share this pom.xml file with you. So that will be easy for you to execute the scripts also. And also you can send out an email so that I can share the pom.xml file. So in pom.xml part is done. We have mentioned the all the plugins and the dependencies, whatever required to execute our Maven test. So I will go to the resources. We have created browser-config.properties. What I will do is here I will mention this particular YouTube URL. I mean youtube.com, I will be mentioning it here. I'll copy this particular URL and here I will say browser dot base URL. So just I will assign this particular value to this particular browser dot base URL. So I'll be using this particular key to access this particular URL. So in another few minutes I'll be discussing how you can read this particular value by using this particular key. So that's it. So let us move on to the futures file. Just I'm opening this future file. So I have already created the future. So if you just I'll copy this and I'll explain you what exactly each of the lines are. It is very simple. If you look at here, so by using the @, I'm identifying this particular future. So here I'm given the UAT testing as the representation for this particular YouTube search validations. Then I have scenario. This you can mention the future, what exactly that particular module is doing and all. This is a scenario like I have mentioned. YouTube search positive scenario. So this is all like with respect to the kind of scenarios you are writing. So these two are the one is future keyword we have used and one more is scenario keyword we have used. Then I have used given, then, sorry, when and then. So these are the Gherkin's keywords. This is already this particular keywords are implemented in the Cucumber framework. Cucumber and Gherkin's jar file. So in the first step, what I'm doing is, this is a very simple English. I have written, open Chrome browser and enter the URL. So in this particular step, what I'll be doing is, I'll be opening my Chrome browser and I'll be entering my URL. And the second step, by using the when keyword, I'm entering the search criteria. Enter search criteria. So that is this particular search criteria. After opening this particular Chrome browser, I'm entering this particular search criteria. Then click on search button. So that's it. Very simple scenario I have taken here. In the first step, I'm opening the Chrome browser and entering the URL. In the second step, in when, I'm entering the search criteria. And then I'm clicking on the search button. So that's it. Let us move on to the test runner. What I'm doing is here, I'll go to my text file. I'll copy this entire lines. And I'll paste it here. Don't worry, I will explain each and every lines, what exactly each of the lines are doing. So once you written this particular code, just import the related packages. So I will explain you one by one each lines. Just give me a second, I will import all the related packages. So that this particular annotation test comes from the testng annotation. Even data provider also comes from the testng annotation. So this particular Cucumber future wrapper also comes from Cucumber API testng. So finally you import this particular after class from test ng annotation. So that's it. So let me explain you what exactly this particular cucumber option contains annotation. So this is a future file where exactly my futures are located. If you look at here, I have specified the ./futures. So here I have specified YouTube search .future, that comes under the futures directory, right? So that's the reason I have specified the futures location, and the glue is contains the step def, where exactly my step definition contains for this all the steps. So there should be implemented somewhere in the in my framework, right? So that's the reason these step implementations are done in the this particular class. So that's it. So that we can do it a little later. So once I explain this particular class, so I'll be implementing the YouTube search criteria, YouTube search step def Java file, then we'll be writing one utility method that reads the test data, I mean the URL from this particular resources. So this glue contains the where exactly my step definitions contains. Tags is nothing but I have given here annotation UAT testing. So this is the name I have provided in the this particular futures file. If you look at here, so I have represented this particular future as a @UAT testing. Then this part is plugin is equal to, this part is for generating our index.html report. If you look at here, I have shown you the one slide. So this particular index.html report, if you write this particular line, these statements, it will generate you the this particular index.html report. So that's it. Let me maximize it. So next part is all the annotations, just it is a before class and annotation test and annotation data provider and annotation after class. So I will explain each of the test methods. If you are not that much clear about the TestNG annotations, I highly recommend you to go to the YouTube. So here you just search by Selenium by Buckappa. So here, if you look at this particular playlist, Selenium quick video tutorials using real-time web applications, click on this particular playlist. Here there are many videos. Come to the video number 32. If you look at here, introduction to TestNG framework annotation and part 2, part 3, part 4 and so on. So these all are very basic for the TestNG annotations and TestNG framework. So I recommend you to watch these videos, so it will be easy for understanding whatever we have written in this particular test runner class. So let me explain you what each of the methods are doing here. This annotation before class, if this particular test method will be getting executed before running any of the test methods in this particular class. So what it is doing is simply it is pointing to the this.get class. So it is getting this particular class and all these properties. So once it has got all the properties, so it is executing the annotation test. This particular annotation test is getting the one parameter called data provider is equal to futures. This particular futures method is implemented here only. So this is the name we have given in the data provider is equal to futures. So what exactly this data provider does is, this particular data provider, it gets the, all the future from this particular location with this tags. One by one, it will process to this particular annotation test. So that time this particular test will be get executed first time. If we have mentioned multiple tags, so multiple futures will be coming from this particular location and it will be executed from the annotation test method. So in this particular after test after class, just it will close this testng cucumber runner connections all the, so which is opened by before class. In this particular method, this particular connections will be opened with the testng cucumber runner, that is the inbuilt class. Testng cucumber runner is the inbuilt class, so just we are by using that reference variable, we are just getting the class and the all the features. Then finally we are closing connection to the testng cucumber runner dot finish. By using the finish method, we are just closing all the connection to the testng cucumber runner. So that's it. So let us create a testng class for this test runner. Right click on the test runner. Here select the option as testng. Here you say convert to testng. So this is where exactly your testng.xml will be getting generated. So here suit name is suit and test is test. You can, if you want to, just you modify this to parameters, and wherever you want you can create a folder and you can keep it this particular testng.xml file. So in my case, let it be like this. So I'm clicking on the finish button. If you look at here, this particular testng file got generated. So if I go to the source tab, so this is a simply, it has pasted the this testng runner dot java is there, right? That particular class fully qualified name is mentioned in this class name. So overview for this particular testng.xml file is, so one is suit tag, you can mention the suit name, and test, you can mention the thread count. At a time it can run 5 tests at a time. Under the classes, we have mentioned the class which we want to run, where we have specified our test runner class. So if I right click on this particular testng class, just run it, run as testng suit. So let us cancel it, just save it all the files. Now you can execute this particular testng.xml file as a testng suit. If you go here, so it is saying configuration failures. So how it can be done is, so still you have not developed any YouTube search criteria, search step dev find the properties file still. So what I will do is, I'll go to this particular step dev package class. Here I'll specify the all the steps definition for the each of the futures in this particular future file. So we have total three steps. For each of the three steps, I have a step definition methods. So I'm going to this particular class. So what I will do is, I'll copy this entire lines. So I will explain you what each of the lines are doing here. Let me maximize it. So here, this is annotation given is nothing but, let me close the others. So I'll open the future file. So annotation given is nothing but this particular first step. So if you see this particular description, open Chrome browser and enter URL. Here you can see that open Chrome browser and enter URL. In the same way, second step we have enter search criteria, and that is in when keyword, right? So in the when keyword you can see enter search criteria. So in the third step, click on search button, we have a click on search button. So that is contains the annotation then. So what I will do is just I will import all the annotation given. Let me import our related packages, but yeah, still I'm not getting this particular packages. So what I will do is I will right click on this particular project and I will say Maven update project. Click on OK button. That's it. So now try if we are getting or not. Still we are not getting any of the annotations to import. Let me close that particular future file. So what I will do is I'll open this particular pom.xml and I'll check what if some errors are there in this particular fix pom.xml. So there are no errors, no wrong with this pom.xml. Let me close this. Let us try now. Now it is not working still. So what I will do is I will right click on this particular project and I will say run. Clean this particular Maven, I will say Maven clean. So it will clean the Maven project. So that's it. And I'll say update Maven project. So that's all. So I think we have some issues here. Okay. Just give me a second, I will look into the issue, what exactly the problem is here. I'm getting Chrome driver, but I'm getting these properties. Let me import the packages and we'll see why we are not getting the for importing annotation given and annotation when. So this is the object what we have created for the reading properties file. So we can implement this particular class, no issues. Let me import manually and we'll check. Just give me a minute, I will check out. Let me check if we are missing some pom.xml dependency. That's correct. If we look at here, we have missed some dependencies. So I will copy this dependency and I'll paste it there. So here, what you need to do is, so we should be very careful in mentioning the dependencies especially. So if I do this, so I should be getting those options now for importing. So if you look at here, I'm getting the import given, and import when, and import then. So these all the features comes from the Cucumber BDD jar file. So that's it. So here it is very simple. Let me implement this particular class properties file reader. So what I will do is I'll go to this particular utility, that is we have given the properties file reader class here. So I will take the code from this particular, not from the pom. So I'll copy this particular method. And I'll paste it. So I will explain you what exactly each of the lines are doing here. Just import all the packages, that's all. So here I have implemented one method called getProperty method. So it returns me this particular data from the properties file. So in our case, I have specified only single browser-config.properties. So we have mentioned only one value, that is browser.baseURL. So how you can use this particular key and how you can get this particular value. So this is where we have a properties file reader class. So I have written here the get property method. So return type of this particular method is properties type. So whenever you call to this particular method, so you need to store the value in terms of properties only. So in the first, just I have specified the file input class and I have assigned the null value. Then I have created the object of properties class. By using the object of this properties, I'm loading this particular location file. If you look at this particular path of this particular under the file input stream, so that is under, if you look at this particular folder structure under resources, we have one file called browser-config.properties. So in the same way, this particular, where exactly this particular location of the browser-config.properties file I have mentioned. So this is the path where exactly my properties file is there. Then I surrounded this particular statement with the try and the catch block. If anything occurred in this particular while loading this particular location file, so that will be catched by the catch statement here. Finally, after loading this particular file, so it will return in terms of properties. By using this object, you can access to that particular whatever you have mentioned under the URL and all. Just I'm closing this. I'm going to the stepdef file. So that's all. Just import the related packages here. So this is the object I have created for this particular class. So if you look at here, just we have implemented this particular class, right, with the get property method. So I have created the object for that properties file reader. That's it. Then I have defined the one static web driver. So by using this driver object, I'm going to find the web elements. In the first step, what I have done is, it is very straightforward. By using the properties, if you look at this properties file reader object, by using this object, I'm getting the property, get property. So I call to the get property method. So after that, I'm storing that into the properties tag. So where by using this properties reference variable, I can access anything specified in this particular browser-config.properties file. So you'll see how we have accessed that particular youtube.com URL. So in the second step, it is very simple. We are launching the Chrome browser. This is where I have kept the my Chrome driver.exe. So after that, I'm launching the Chrome driver and we are maximizing it in this line. Then if you hear, we will be mentioning manually before in the Selenium tutorials. But now what I have did is, by using this properties object, I'm using get property method. And after that, I'm specifying this key value. If you look at here, we need to mention the proper key value here. I'll go to this particular properties file. I'll copy this particular key and I'll fetch this youtube.com as a URL. So I'll paste it here as a key. That's it. I will delete this line. Not required. So this is a very first step what we have in the future file. In the second step, what I'm doing is, in the first step, just we are launching the browser and we are entering this URL, and after entering this particular URL, we need to enter this particular value into search box and we need to click on this particular button, right? So that's the reason I'm identifying this particular search element by using the ID. So if you look at here, ID is equal to search we have. So that's the reason I have specified the ID here. Just import the by from the Selenium. So here I'm entering some value. So I'll say Selenium by Buckappayan. So by using Sunkist, I'm sending the data in the second step. So first step, what it is doing, it is opening the Chrome browser and entering the URL. In the second step, we are doing enter search criteria. So I have identified this particular search text box, and I'm sending this particular value to that field. Then in the third step, I'm clicking on the search button. So I have identified this particular button by using the CSS selector. If you copy this particular value, click on the HTML tags, press Ctrl F, then paste the value. So if you look at here, it is identifying that particular web element. So that's it. So what I have done is, just I have used the ID value. If you look at here, ID is equal to search icon legacy, right? So just before this particular value, I have used a hash symbol. That is nothing but our CSS selectors. So after that, we need to click on this particular button, right? So that's the reason we need to call to the click method. That's it. So our step definition file is ready. Let me close all the things. So we have created step def file, test runner package and utility method. In this YouTube search step def file, we have all the steps we implemented. That is, one is opening browser and entering the URL. In the second step, we are entering search criteria. In the third step, we are clicking on that particular search button. So that's it. The test runner, we have specified where exactly my future file is there. and where exactly my step definition file contains. In the tags, we have specified where what is the future, what exactly we have represented that particular future by using the annotation at the rate, and this is for the HTML report format. And after that, we are using annotation before class and after class. In between, we are used annotation test and annotation data provider to get the all the futures. So that's it. From the properties file reader, just we are loading this particular file, where particular file, and we are returning the properties. By using this particular object, we are accessing that in the YouTube search step def file. That is, here we are accessing this particular URL in the step definition file. So that's it. And we have in the futures, we have specified the scenario. In the resources, we have specified the URL. So that's it. What I will do is I will right click on this particular testng.xml file. I'll say run as testng suite. We should be very careful in mentioning the pom.xml. So that's the reason we have faced little bit issue. So you can comment in the comment section so that I can share my pom.xml file. So that will be helping you a lot in executing Selenium BDD scripts. So if you look at here, only one test scenario, it is got passed. There are zero failures and zero skipped. And if you come to this particular target under this, just refresh one time this particular project. So if you come here under the site, under Cucumber Pretty, so here you'll be seeing the index.html. Double click on this index.html. Here you'll be seeing that particular future, what exactly that future contains, description, then the scenario name. Under that, we have only three steps specified, right? One is opening the browser and entering the URL and search criteria and clicking on the search button. So if you look at here, all the steps are got passed, and if something is got failed, here you'll be seeing the all the description. Let me show you the failed scenario. What I'll do is I'll go to step def file. Here I'll say, instead of identifying this particular CSS selector, I'll just modify, I'll specify the wrong CSS selector. So let us see how it will run. So it should throw us the error. So if I run this particular testng.xml file, so it should say no such element found exception and all. That should be printed in the index.html report. If I go here, it is saying no such a element found exception, because it is not able to identify that particular search button with the selector value. If I go to this particular index.html, so all the exception information is printed over here. So whatever printed on the screen in the console, all the information you can see in the index.html report. So that's all I have in this Selenium Cucumber BDD framework development. If you have any questions, you can drop me an email to my Gmail ID. So next Selenium Cucumber BDD tutorial with page object model. Stay tuned for the next tutorial. Click on subscribe button to get more updates from this particular channel. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching this Selenium Cucumber BTT tutorial.